Let you all open all your three eyes.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
In this sacred manual of power manifestation, which serves as a scriptural authority containing the Shastra Pramanas, eternal unchangeable truths, Apta Pramanas, Atma Pramanas, Sakshi Pramanas, and Prataksha Pramanas, we present to you the various powers of Paramashiva. By this, we place before humanity the supreme authenticity of the power manifestation science established by the Supreme Pontiff of Hinduism, Jagat Guru Mahasannidhanam, His Divine Holiness Nityananda Paramashivam. Paramashiva has systematically revealed these powers in their purest forms as various techniques and revelations to experience pure oneness with Paramashiva. As a direct experience of oneness with Paramashiva, His Shaktis powerfully manifest in an initiated being at different levels of human consciousness, physicality, physiology, psychology, and neurology permanently. We offer these power manifestation manuals to celebrate your experience of oneness with the Supreme Paramashiva. Nityanandam.
Akashic readings. Does life exist on other planets? What is the truth of the Bermuda Triangle mystery? Find out about my past lives? The hallways of Kala Chakra hide many answers. Get answers to all these questions and more directly from the source, the Cosmic Archives. Cosmic Archives are the mystical records of all the events, words, thoughts, and actions that have ever happened in the cosmos. The time shaft can be rewound and fast-forwarded for answers that only a living incarnation can access. Now, for the first time, a living avatar who is the embodiment of the cosmos itself opens himself in a language that we can understand. Akashic readings. Google the Cosmic Archives.
Nityanandam, Jnanapatiti Manual, under the guidance of Supreme Pontiff of Hinduism, Jagatguru Mahasannidhanam, His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Nityananda Paramashivam. Let's start with the Sadguru Vandanam. Nityanandam Paramasukhanam Kevalam Jnanamurtim Dvandvatitam Gaganasadushnam Tattvamasyadilakshyam Ekam Nityam Vimalamachalam Sarvadi Sakshibhutam Bhavatitam Trigunarahitam Sadgurum Tam Namami. Let's go through the disclaimers. Security measures. No photography, video, audio, recording. Important cautions. Please be aware of the important cautions. What is power manifestation? Let's hear from Bhagwan himself explaining what is power manifestation.
All the 25 states of consciousness, when they happen in you, due to your chemicals and hormones, ups and downs, it is powerlessness. When it happens in you, out of your free will and consciousness, it is powerfulness. That's all. When you fall into sleep, it is powerlessness. When you enter into sleep, it is powerfulness. When you fall into dream, it is powerlessness. When you decide to dream, it is powerfulness. So I have added the ultimate powerfulness. Turiyatita, turiyatita, in your whole being and doing, manifest all the powers. Understand, power manifestation is nothing but cognitive shift. It is not work. It is cognitive shift. Understand? It is just cognitive shift. It's not work. Work is a four-letter word. Power manifestation is cognitive shift. Playing with life. Playing with being alive. Static matter, dynamic activity, strategic existence, all these three has no boundary. You are one with it. You are alive in everything. Everything listens to you. Everything decides as you want. Power manifestation is cognitive shift, raising your frequency, not work.
Now let's understand who is Paramashiva. Bhagwan himself has beautifully explained the Paramashiva in all of us.
Paramashiva does manifestation, maintenance, rejuvenation, pulling out of delusion and liberation. He resides in his supreme Paramashiva Swarupa as Ajomuha or Adomuha, unborn. Beyond form, formlessness. His Paramashiva Swarupa. That Paramashiva Swarupa manifests with these five faces. As Sadashiva, Tatpurusha, Vamadeva, Ahora, Satyojata, Ishana, five faces he manifests and does the Panjakritya, Srishti, manifestation, Stiti, sustenance, Samhara, rejuvenation, Trubhava, pulling out of delusion, Anugraha, liberation. Understand? He does all these five jobs. Through these five faces. Now, listen carefully. Tatpurusham, Vamadevam, Satyojatam, Ahoram, Ishanam. These five faces does Panchakrityas. Each face, each dimension is not just one F-A-C-E face, P-H-A-S-E, face. It's not just F-A-C-E, P-H-A-S-E. Understand? The creation. Not just creation getting created. Even sustenance need to be created. Destruction need to be created. And pulling out of delusion need to be created. Liberation need to be created. Then creation, manifestation need to be maintained.
maintenance, sthiti itself need to be maintained. Destruction, samhara, the rejuvenation need to be sustained, maintained when it is happening. Pulling out of delusion, throbava, need to be maintained when it is happening. And anugraha, liberation, need to be maintained when it is happening. Those micro milliseconds when it is happening. So understand, Satyojata Murti as five face. Ishanamurti as five face. Vamadeva Murti as five face. Agora Murti as five face. Tatpurusha Murti as five face. So, Tatpurusha Murti as is five face. Agora Murti has is five face. Vamadeva Murti has is five face. Satyojata Murti has his five face. Ishana Murti has his five face. All these five Murtis, five faces put together is 25 faces of Mahasadashiva.
Bhagavan beautifully explained Parameshiva. Now, who is His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Nityananda Parameshivam? Let's hear from Bhagavan Himself. Supreme Pontiff of Hinduism, Jagatguru Mahasannidhanam, His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Nityananda Parameshivam, is a reviver of Kailasha, the ancient enlightenment civilization, the great cosmic borderless nation. Is an avatar from and is a Supreme Pontiff of Hinduism. His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Nityananda Parameshivam, has made science of our manifestation, yoga, temple-based university, for humanity, so which in order of Kailasha led by His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Nityananda Parameshwam and Nityananda order of monks, nuns, Hindu diasporas are working for global peace to give superconscious breakthrough to humanity. Nityananda Hindu University, world's largest with extended campus in 150 countries, is collecting, organizing, preserving, time capsuling, decoding, spreading and reviving 20 million source books of Hinduism and 64 sacred arts, science like Ayurveda, music, dance, sculpting, astrology, Vastu, and many more. His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Nityananda Parameshivam, is 293rd Guru Mahasannidhanam of Shamala Pita Sarvanya Pita, ancient apex body of Hinduism and present emperor of Suryavamsa Surangi Swamrajyam. His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Nityananda Parameshivam, has survived the worst prosecution of multiple assassination attempts on person and character by anti-Hindu elements. Beautifully, Bhagavan now explains who is His Divine Holiness, Bhagavan Nityananda Parameshivam.
Everything is infinitely powerful. You realize your potentiality. You establish yourself in the completion, space of completion. You are God, that's all. All of us are gods. The first experience is that I was able to see everything around me, above me, the whole 360 degree. I realized not only I was able to see, I was able to feel, experience the skin of the stone on rock on which I was sitting and the skin of this body, both carry me equally. In both I exist equally. Sandha is a place where the tattvas are taught to you, and till it becomes satya, you are supported. A Arcadas are basically founded by Sadashiva himself. All is Ganas, Shiva Ganas. Exactly the word Gana means. In your length, breadth, depth, if you are filled by Shiva, you are Shiva Gana. All the Shiva Ganas formed the first Arcada. Later on, much later, Kapila Muni organizes Mahanirvani Arcada. Then all other Arcadas. As Mahamandaleshwar of Mahanirvani Arcada, the oldest apex body of Hinduism, I welcome every one of you. What I am teaching is from original Agamas Yogapada. The science very clearly declares, Sadashiva is very clear, manifestation of these powers happen when you experience oneness with Sadashiva. When you choose your guru, the best thing is find a person who is enlightened, experienced, who can play with energy, who can directly transmit experience to you, and who is in tune with the original Shastras, the source of the knowledge. All the revealed scriptures available about the yoga directly by Sadashiva for you to do research, study, practice, question the people who teach.
The science of power manifestation is a gift to the humanity which is authentic, time-tested, scientific and foolproof. Diksha or the initiation from His Divine Holiness Nityananda Parameshwara makes the science directly an experience for the initiates. The experience is directly authenticated by the Pramanas. The Shastra Pramanas, the eternal unchangeable truth revealed in the source scriptures, the Veda and Agamas. The Apta Pramanas, the experience of the Rishis, Munis, Ganas, Nayanamars, Alvars and Siddhars, who are the authority of Hinduism, who are scientists, who time-tested and verified the science of power manifestation. The Atma Pramanas are the avatar who land on the planet Earth to give a superconscious breakthrough to humanity. His Divine Holiness Bhagavan Nityananda Parameshwara, this millennium's avatar, personal experience of power manifestation. Shakshi Pramanas are the experience of the millions of disciples, devotees and followers initiated into the science of power manifestation by Bhagavan himself. Pratyaksha Pramanas are the scientific studies which can be measured, measuring the effect of being in the enlightened state.
Powerful cognition from Living Advaita series from Bhagavan Satsang.
It'll all be too small. By remembrance, you should be able to throw it. Krato smara kridagun smara. Krato smara kridagun smara. When you leave the body, your ability to remember the need of the enlightenment, merging into the cosmos, and ability to provoke the cosmos to absorb you into it. The ability to provoke the cosmos, if you lived your whole life with a deep prayerful experience, now the prayer will become reality. praying to yourself is completion. Completion with the cosmos is prayer. You telling yourself, hey, remember what all you did just for this moment. And don't look here and there. Enough pizza, enough Coca-Cola, enough curd rice, enough pickles? No. Kratosmara kridagnusmara. Don't worry. By the time the pain starts, the death pain, all your name and fame, greed to rule the kingdom, sex, lust, everything will lose meaning for you, will lose power over you. It'll only be the last one or two things which you did not build defense, which you did not build completion, which you left it in a casual way, unattended way. I have seen people while they die, they do not remember the person with whom they want to have a physical relationship for their whole life, but they will remember the person with whom they want to flirt. Because the deeper things will disappear, will not make any sense there. These casual things will happen because about the casual things you would not have built the defense. You would not have internalized. You would not have built completion. Vayura nilamamrutam thetam vayura nilamamrutetam amrutamadetam vayura nilamamrutamadetam basmandagnu sariram. Om krato smara kridagnu smara. Krato smara kridagnu smara. Vayura nilamamrutam. Let the life in the body merge with the cosmic life. Let the body go back to its basic elements and be reduced to ashes. O cosmos, please remember what all I have done to achieve oneness with you. O being, please remember what all you have done to achieve oneness with him. So reminding both sides and making that oneness happen. I wanted Vakyartha Sadas to be done on this verse from the angle of reminding the cosmos and reminding yourself. The first, Om Krato Smara Kridagnu Smara. Next, Krato Smara Kridagnu Smara. The second, Kratosmara Kridagnusmara, is completion of your muscle memory and biomemory. The first, Om Kratosmara Kridagnusmara, is awakening your bioenergy. The second, Kratosmara Kridagnusmara, is completion and Shivoham process. The first, Om Kratosmara Kridagnusmara, is Nityananda home process, awakening your bioenergy. Awakening your bioenergy. Om Krato Smara Kridagnu Smara. Krato Smara Kridagnu Smara. Do Vakyartha Sadas on this last line. I'll continue to expand on these verses, especially on this verse. I'll expand and present this as a meditation technique so that all of you can practice it and experience it. Now, essence of today's satsang, reminding the cosmos about your goal, is prayer. Reminding yourself about your goal is completion. Reminding yourself is completion. Reminding the cosmos is prayer. The first Om Kratosmara Kridagnusmara is prayer. Second Kratosmara Kridagnusmara is completion. The essence of today's satsang, prayer and completion, both leads you to enlightenment.
Let's go to the Shastra Pramana, eternal unchangeable truth revealed in the source scriptures.
The Shastra Pramana for the power of remote viewing or Akashic reading is taken from the Vaijnana Bhairava Tantra, Sutra 84, Dharana 61. Akasham vimalam pashyan kritva drishtim nirantaram stabhatma takshana devi bhairavam vaburabnuyat. Akasham vimalam pashyam kritva drishtim nirantaram stabdhatma takshana devi bhairavam vaburabnuyat.
Vijnana Bhairava Tantra, Sutra 84, Dharana 61. Bhagavan Paramashiva says, looking at the spotless, infinite etheric space, Akasha, beyond the sky and the clouds, one should fix one's gaze without blinking and continuously make the body inner space steady and motionless. In the very moment, O Devi, one attains the nature and powers of infinite space, Bhairava. Bhagavan beautifully says how the goal becomes prayer when it is for cosmos, and how the individual, how we exist, our goal becomes the completion. The completion or the prayer, when you align both in the higher reality, that bioenergy or biomemory and muscle memory, taking the whole thing to consciousness as the ultimate. Whichever way he gives, he makes us understand that only consciousness exists as reality, and living as consciousness and experiencing as body, experiencing all the things which are happening in the world, is the ultimate way of existence. He takes us to the higher way of existing and how we can live as conscious beings. The evolution has slowly taken the whole humanity from different possibilities, from the fish to monkey to monkey to man, and now the consciousness being the very source of how we should exist. Bhagavan is giving us the breakthrough to live as conscious being. We had the Alvars, Nayanamars, Rishis, Munis, all these people have lived on the planet Earth, experiencing and living as consciousness as the ultimate. Here, Bhagavan is giving us a beautiful method of how we can exist as consciousness. Whether we are praying or we are in the completion space, we are from the space of oneness. When we function from the space of oneness, it simply becomes the reality as consciousness. Only when the identity comes, then comes the confusion. The mind constantly wants to create some identity to satisfy, to protect, to gives all the ideas for us and goes on telling us that it is some possibility that we have to live. But beautifully, the space of how we exist is completely different. The consciousness, how we exist, is completely from the space of oneness. How we can exist as only Paramashanta space, Paramashanta Swarupa, the restful awareness inside happens only when we are in the completion. Clearly making ourselves understand the whole thing is redundant and irrelevant. How much ever you do it in the dream, when you wake up, you are very clear, it does not matter. You are in complete completion. The same completion in the world, if we can bring it, that brings us to the beautiful unclad space. And assigning ourselves to the higher reality that I am consciousness. I work from the space of consciousness, creating this body, creating this mind, and creating everything. Now the mind, Bhagwan says, is worse than a politician. At least he might do something. Here, consciousness. The mind does not do anything except not allow the consciousness. It binds the consciousness and controls us into believing that we are in only the space of that impossibility. When we are intense and we are grounded, whenever we are grounded and establish ourselves, then the mind simply disappears. Bhagwan says, Buddha, when he declared, my body is ready to evaporate, but I'm not going to move. Whenever we have a very strong, constant declaration, grounding ourselves with the intensity and continuity, the mind disappears and we flow as consciousness. The more and more the integrity that I am Paramashiva starts happening, the grounding becomes very real. And how Bhagwan says, the prayer and the completion both leads to the enlightened space. The only thing we need to experience is the grounding and intensity and continuity in grounding that I am Paramashiva in any situation that is happening. When we ground completely, then we wake up to a new conscious space where it becomes the bioenergy catches up and we move to the complete completion, perpetual completion, the enlightened space itself. Till that happens, the intensity and continuity of the Paramashiva is my only space. And then the O Devi, simply it becomes, one attains the nature and power of infinite space that Bhagwan is speaking about. The Bhairava simply happens in us as reality. With this powerful cognition, let's move to Apta Pramana. Apta Pramana are the authorities of Hinduism, the Vedic Rishi and scientists who time-tested and verified the science of power manifestation. Revelation of past tragedy through Akashic reading. Now here, source is Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter 13, Text 15. Vidura was revealed by the sage Maitreya that he was an incarnation of Lord Yama. And because of the curse given by the Manduka Muni, he was reincarnated on planet Earth as Vidura. Vidura left for the pilgrimage after being humiliated by Duryodhana. During the course of his pilgrimage, he came to Vrindavan. Vidura went to the hermitage of a sage, Maitreya, along with the Uddhava and sought wisdom. Sage Maitreya told Vidura the story of his birth in a human form and reason of all his suffering. Sage Maitreya told Vidura that he was not an ordinary man, but was in fact the incarnation of Yamaraj,
Lord of Death. He was to play the past and so-called Sundara for 100 years. Because being cursed by Mantukamuni, he was the incarnation of Yamaraja. Yamaraja was always busy in his kingdom punishing the doers of sinful act, but he wanted to preach the glories of the Lord, and therefore by the will of the Lord he was cursed by Mandukamuni to come into the world in the incarnation of Vidura and work very hard as a great devotee. Beautifully, Srimad Bhagavatam gives a great revelation about Vidura's previous past life. And with this, let's go to the Atma Pramana, the Akashic records.
When the birthing happens, if the child is kept without the umbilical cord being cut for at least few minutes, then the mother can experience two souls. The moment child comes out, the individual soul enters. Mother has one individual soul, the child has another one individual soul. The umbilical cord connection exists between two souls. Mother, taking up the responsibility of birthing and preparing her consciousness for 9 months, and while giving the birth, she can achieve enlightenment. And after the birthing happens, without cutting the umbilical cord, if you remain, keep the child as it is, the individual soul which enters the child's body will have the initiation from the enlightened mother through the umbilical cord, which is the most powerful connection. The umbilical cord initiation directly makes the child experience enlightenment, and enlightened biomemory basis forms the basic experience of the child. When the enlightened biomemory forms the basis of a child, naturally child will grow as Jivan Mukta, living enlightened.
The next question is from Induja and Sinduja from Chennai. Nityanandam Swamiji, can you please tell us about twins' birth? Why two souls are born together? Is there any specific reason for it? And do the souls have the same purpose in life?
There is no such thing as two souls born together. Only two bodies are created together, and the possibility for the two souls enter is created. Otherwise, the twins, even if they are born physically connected, has no spiritual connection. Even if the connection felt by few twins is psychological.
The next question is from Bodhana. Nityanandam, dear Kala Bhairava, does the body need to be left undisturbed for a period of time after death? If so, how long? In the Tibetan Book of Death, it sounds as if some souls take a while to move on. If we wish the highest possible evolution for the soul, can body organs and the body be given over immediately to science upon the verdict of brain dead? Or should the body be left undisturbed for a period of time?
If the body is left undisturbed, the remaining karmas will be transferred to the new body in next 13 days.
But if you give the organs, part of the body, to any research or science for any purpose, that does not interfere the karma shifting process. Even if those organs are living in other body or being separated from your body and used for some other purpose, the karma baggage shifting process does not get disturbed. So the organ donation do not interfere any way your death process. The moment brain dead is declared, the parts of the body can be donated. It does not interfere in the karma baggage transferring process. When a death happens, the individual reflection takes the next body within 3 chana. The karma baggage gets transferred in 13 days.
She is also asking if we have taken NSP, do the practices from the Tibetan Book of Death need to be invoked? How do we know if someone is enlightened upon death and therefore should be buried and not cremated?
Stop. The conscious experience which you receive from the program NSP by Nityananda gives you a complete possibility of innate intelligence which awakens by itself through the experience of death. So what you understand by the Tibetan Book of Dead need not be invoked, as this process in a complete comprehensive conscious way is already inserted, programmed in your system by the conscious experience in the NSP. Next question.
How do we know if someone is enlightened upon death and therefore should be buried and not cremated, as Kalabhairava stated on Akashic Readings?
Both eyeballs will naturally move towards the third eye. If the both eyeballs have moved towards the third eye and they are centered towards the third eye, is enlightened being, and face does not carry any visible stress, again is an enlightened being. And the throat will not become stiff. If you put your finger on the throat, you can feel still it is alive, he is living. An enlightened being's throat does not become stiff, frozen, cold, are like wood even after he leaves the body. So these few symptoms will make you understand this person, whether he became enlightened before leaving the body. This can be used as a scale to decide whether the body should be buried or cremated.
The next question is from Shrikant Gopi. Dear Kala Bhairava, how can we grow younger each year? How can we achieve eternity physically and merge with light while in physical body?
I'll give you the signs used by Tirunjnana Sambandha and the great saint like Vallalar and Sant Jnaneshwar. Every night, complete all the engrams you build, all the samskaras you build should be completed by going through the death process every night before falling asleep. Every night, if you go through the death process and complete and fall asleep, there will not be any remaining engrams, samskaras, which is responsible for getting old. The time will not act on you. The bridge through which time acts on you, time enters into your consciousness, is samskaras. Engrams is the bridge through which time enters you. If you break the bridge, time will not be able to enter in your inner space. You will be free from time. The person who is free from time grows younger, younger, younger due to his experience to live untouched by time and samskaras. This is the only and best way to grow younger and disappear into the pure light consciousness, the cosmic soul, without leaving the remains of the physical body.
He is also asking, is it possible to achieve this siddhi through the 2012 transition? I would like to transcend death and live for another 200 years. Please advise.
It is possible through this technique. You don't even need to worry about this 2012. Do it and have it.
The next question is from Anne Mary Kasu. Swamiji said at satsang that after 65, body and mind were useless. Then what is the use of living longer? Why doesn't life end there?
The bodies and minds unused, unprepared, will not be useful after 65. If you prepare it from the young age, use properly, it will continue to be useful. You never reach the state of 65.
She is also saying, I am over 65 and I feel quite alive and enthusiastic. It is very hard for me to accept, as my greatest fear is being unwanted. Is seva useless after 65, no matter how many hours and how much pleasure and enthusiasm is fed into it? Is our life purpose over, whether accomplished or not?
This is individual question. Bring it in evening Kalabhairava Darshan.
The next question is from Vidya Ramasamy from Singapore. Nityanandam, dear Swamiji, what is the role of doctors in disease and death?
Doctors are also groping in unconsciousness. So when the unconsciousness is playing with unconsciousness, nobody has a clear role in disease or death.
Let's go to the Sakshi Pramana. Sakshi Pramanas are the experience of the devotees and the disciples and Balasins. Here we have the Balasins narrating his experience of Akashic reading and materialization.
My experiences which I from my life. In this experience, this is all about how I was able to materialize Vibhuti after the Akashic readings. So what happened was, on October 22nd and 23rd, I hosted a Nitya Dhyan 2-day program to online centers like Toronto, Vancouver, Calgary and few other centers. So there was intense participation from the Vancouver center. So I was very pleased about that. And in this, what happens is that after every chakra, the program is basically about the 7 chakras in your body and how they are the energy centers in your body. So every center, energy center, is related to one particular power. So during the end of the whole program, the 2 days program, on October 23rd, I had an Akashic reading session with them, where I just got into the space of I am Sadashiva, I am Swamiji, I am Nityananda. And after getting into that space, Kalabhairava was so happy with all of them that when somebody came, he blessed all of them that all of you will be cause for this Sadashivoham 2016, and as a mark of all of you will be cause for this 2016 Sadashivoham, you will have Vibhuti materialized on the Padukas, on the Atmamurti, all over the place. And this was the blessing which was given. And immediately, within the evening, that day evening in Vancouver, They saw Vibhuti materialized on Swamiji's Atma Murti, various places in Swamiji's Atma Murti, and it was literally like somebody has put the powder, like from hands of, if you drop powder, how it is. So it's like dropped in front of the Atma Murti. So much of Vibhuti materialized. And this is one of my most like first experiences where I am able to materialize Vibhuti, not just here, but from here to somewhere which is so many miles away, hundreds of miles away from where I am staying. I was here in Bidadi, in Bengaluru Adinam, conducting the session over the two-way conferencing, and the Vibhuti materialized in Vancouver. And there were about 10 people who are physically present, who witnessed the whole thing, and they have taken this and they have also posted about it in the Facebook, and we have clear recorded photograph and evidence of this Vibhuti being materialized. So I am very grateful to Swamiji for giving me this opportunity to be able to be a channel for Swamiji to flow through me. Thank you, Nityananda.
Pratyaksha Pramana, scientific studies what can be measured, measuring the effect of being in enlightenment state. The science behind Akashic reading. As time exists simultaneously as a dimension of space, all energy or information, energy is nothing but subjective information, is waiting to be decoded depending on the parameters and objects used. To explain this with a simple analogy, electricity is coded energy and is decoded in an object called a light bulb and thus manifests as the light. At a classical level, all information is stored in bits in computer language as a binary of 0 and 1, which is then decoded by the software of the computer. As mentioned earlier, at the quantum level, information is stored as qubits. These qubits of information are present across the entire fabric of the cosmos and represent the entire information held within the cosmos in time and space. Interestingly, at the quantum level, the binary system exists as 0 and 1 separately, but happens simultaneously and concurrently, such that both 0 and 1 exist at the same time. Information regarding past, present, or future of a quantum nature is available, waiting to be decoded, but at the present moment, there exists no technology in science which can work as a true quantum computer and has the software to understand all the information and underlying principles of the cosmos. Biologically, the human brain has been linked to the equivalent of quantum computer. An avatar in the form of being, like Sri Nityananda Paramashivam, is able to access the qubits of information stored across the cosmos as Akashic readings, as he himself is both the software and the hardware, the subject and the object of the quantum universe. Source taken from Avatar Shastra, Chapter 3, Akashic Reading, page 90. We will now introduce a video on Retrieve Your Akashic Records by the Avatar himself, Sri Nityananda Paramashivam, on the morning of 29th March 2011 at Bidadi Ashram, Bengaluru, India.
Please understand, any action you do just based on the physical body will leave its wave and the archive in physical layer. All your physical actions get gathered and archived in the physical layer of the cosmos. Understand? Even a small act you do, like a simple eating, gets recorded in your file in the cosmic physical archives. Same way, any small thought crosses your mind, like, I think I should go and lie down and sleep. Even this simple thought gets recorded in your mental layer as a file and stored in the cosmic archives. Anything happened from the beginning in all seven levels, in all beings, is available alive. Understand? 3,000 years before, when you were in the pig body or buffalo body or elephant body or dinosaur body, what you thought on particular day and particular moment can be retrieved without any corruption or mismanagement or alteration. Whole thing is available. If the action which you did is performed from the first layer, it will be available in first layer file. If it is from second layer, it will be available from the second layer file. If it is from third layer of your body, it will be available from third layer of the file. But one important thing is, billions and billions of first layer files are available. Millions and millions of second layer files are available. But only thousands of third layer files are available, because people don't function from second layer and third layer. Understand? So when you go deeper and deeper and deeper, only few thousand or few hundred files are available from the seventh layer actions.
Each individual's DNA holds his personal Akashic records. Science says that the human species has evolved with a two-stranded DNA, which is found in every cell, which determines the form as well as the potential diseases and skills we can have. Scientists are very clear that what we think is not our original blueprint, because we are able to study only one part of the DNA till now. The other unrevealed part, which scientists have not been able to study or logically understand its function, they have labeled as junk DNA or shadow DNA. Scientists are absolutely right when they say there are two parts in the DNA, and one part which they are able to study is responsible for the form and diseases. The other part is what is responsible for our spiritual gifts. I tell you, the other part is what carries all the siddhis and superhuman powers. I can say the part which is already discovered is junk DNA. The part which is not yet discovered, or maybe I can use the word yet to be realized, it is this part that contains information about who you really are on a level of spiritual beingness. It is that part to which I gave the name Jivatma, the individual consciousness, or individual self DNA. It is that part which carries our divine personality. By His Divine Holiness, Sri Nityananda Paramashivam.
Setting up for Akashic reading, camera with timestamp, Nyananjan, pencil and paper, Atma Murthy and a partner. Explain to the partner step by step how you'll be doing the whole process. Set up the camera. Download the timestamp app. Click on the video. Ensure the time is shown on the screen vividly and clearly. Make sure the camera is facing you and the partner in a wide angle. Make sure the place is very well lit and there is no background noise. These are Shakti Avishkarna videos. Make sure you don't miss recording all these great moments. Guidelines: turn on the video recording, apply the Nyananjan in your third eye, bring your awareness to your third eye, offer the Guru Puja, ask the partner to write the past tragedy and scan and write the past tragedy as seen on the third eye through the Atma Murthy in golden letters and also the reason for it. Verify what is revealed are the same past tragedies and written by the partner, if it matches exactly, and also the revelation of the reasons are accepted by the partner. Wonderful, you have manifested the power. If you're just feeling the Kundalini energy or you're feeling like some of them is correct, you started manifesting more and more, share with the friends and family. You will start seeing more manifestation happen. Verify authentically the steps. All these steps are revealed in the camera very clearly. Share that video with friends and family with powerful cognition and listen to others' experience of power manifestation for more entanglement.
Power manifestation instructions. Let's sit straight, the head, neck and back in a straight line, so that beautifully the Kundalini energy raises to the Agnya where the manifestation happens. Usually our awareness is on Muladhara, Swadhisthana and Manipuraha, where navel center, your below navel center. Here, bringing the awareness to your third eye and sitting straight will give us amazing possibility of power manifestation. Now let's understand few words that Bhagavan is repeatedly using. Shakti Pada oneness, be unclutched, initiation. So here first we will see in Bhagwan's words, what is Shakti Pada?
Let me give an introduction about what is Shakti Pada process. Please understand. You would have seen or heard about how the chicken sits on the egg and hatches. Of course, in the modern countries, this does not happen. Machine sits on the egg and or egg sits on the machine. In those days, originally when hens and chicken were getting produced on the planet Earth, the hen used to sit on the chicken and hen used to sit on the egg and the chicken will come out of the egg. See, same way, Sadashiva, sitting means the ultimate cosmic energy sitting on the individual soul and making the individual soul into cosmic energy is Shaktipada. Hen sitting on the egg and making the chicken happen, same way. You may think, how come, what is going on here, that hen is only sitting just by the body heat of the hen, and the egg is becoming chicken? Because no surgery is done and nothing goes inside. It's only sitting. Same way, it is just sitting. It's only the presence, the Shaktipada, makes the individual soul into cosmic soul.
Beautifully, Bhagavan explained Shaktipada, how individual soul becomes cosmic soul. And let's listen to initiation.
You see, let me explain the initiation. Initiation is the process beyond your intellectual understanding. The transmission of lamp happens. Now, you understood something intellectually. There is something which is not understood, which can't be transmitted through the words. That is transmitted. That's what we call initiation. Sometime I tell people that unless you are initiated, the techniques do not create the result. The reason is, you do not grasp completely whatever is expressed through words. Initiation is like it just transmits whatever need to be transmitted beyond logic and beyond words. People ask me, why to wear this bracelet or this mala and all those things? This all will remind you. Why bracelet in the hand? It will remind you, before eating, did you meditate? It's a constant reminder. Before eating, let you be reminded, did you do the meditation? That is why this bracelet. That is why this mala. That is why this external things. Sometimes, this external things does a big job of reminding you constantly. That is why, take the help of external things also, nothing wrong. People ask me, why we can just be spiritual without having external things? If you can, really you are welcome. But I don't think anybody who speaks in that way is successful. I have never seen people becoming successful avoiding the external things, just having internal things. And it is just a nice way of escaping from yourself.
Beautifully, Bhagwan explained initiation. Let's listen to be unclutched. What is to be unclutched?
The thoughts. Every thought is independent, illogical, unconnected, and unclutched. Because the gap between two thoughts is too small. the neutral space between the two thoughts is too small, you think all the thoughts are connected and it is in the shape form. It is not. By your very nature, every thought is independent, illogical, unconnected, and unclutched. Between every thought, you experience a neutral space. When you change the gear, whether you go from neutral to 1 or 1 to 2 or 2 to 3 or 3 to 4 or 4 to whatever, whatever gears you may change, but every time you have to come to the neutral space. Only then you can go to the next gear. Even if you want to go from 2 to 3, you have to come to the neutral space. Only then you can go to 3. Same way, between every thought, you experience a neutral space. You experience a neutral space between every thought. Between every thought, that neutral space, that silence is what I call peace or bliss. The peace which exists, the bliss which exists already in you, between every thought, the gap of the thought, the gap between the thoughts, that neutral space is the peace, is the bliss. When you understand you are unconnected, independent, illogical, and unclutched, by your very nature, you will start experiencing the neutral space in you, neutral space which exists in you. You will start living from moment to moment in spontaneity. We need to understand one more thing. This technique of be unclutched, it does miracles in your being. In the body level, or in the mental level, or in the being level. In every level, when you understand the truth, by your very nature, you are unclutched. The tremendous quantum transformation. You take a quantum jump. The transformation happens in quantum, not step by step. Just one jump. You take a quantum jump and experience the truth awakening in you.
The oneness space is the most beautiful space that Bhagavan himself is explaining how we are ferocious. Beyond the tiredness and boredom, we can experience the space of oneness and be unclutched.
Oneness is not imagination. Oneness is not visualization. Oneness is not even just declaration. It is your existence. An idea which is you is oneness. The idea which has become part of your very space, which does not tire you or bore you by the passage of the time, is oneness. Mahadeva says in the Agama, Sadashiva beautifully explains in the Agama, Kala, Yama, cannot tire you or bring boredom to you if something becomes your space. Devi achieved the blissful state and union with Mahadeva on Shivaratri day because our space became oneness. Anything which brings tiredness or boredom has not yet become your space. If living in this body
brings you tiredness and boredom. You are not going to be living in this body forever. When that becomes too much, you are going to drop it and move ahead. If you want to be in oneness forever, it should become part of your space. Means you should become ferocious with you and break this very tiredness and boredom. Only when you deal you with the ferociousness, you break the tiredness and boredom. With that ferociousness, you need to make oneness as your space. Anything stands as an imagination in the length level, visualization in the breadth level, declaration in the depth level. If you open your time with ferociousness, it just sinks into space level. With this ferociousness, the time layer in you opens and the oneness from imagination to visualization to declaration, it becomes your space, the way of existence.
The most important, Bhagavan says, being unclutched, understanding the Shaktipada, the oneness space, and chanting the Mahavakya. The Mahavakya, the power of the Mahavakya, pushes you into the higher states of consciousness. Here Bhagavan himself explains how we can experience the Shaktipada, raised higher consciousness, through Mahavakya.
It's one of the very important revelation by Sadashiva. All the electronic equipments work when the electrons are made to vibrate. That happens by the light. When the electricity is supplied, the light particle vibrates, the electronic equipment starts working. Just like that, the spiritual power and the umbilical cord connection, spiritual umbilical cord connection between you and me, it works with sound particle. For example, my integrity with the cosmos, Sadashiva, Mahasadashiva, it reverberates in certain level of frequency. When you are integrated to me, you also start reverberating in the same frequency. If your integrity goes down, that is when you start connecting with me only as a manager or this organization head or your Purvashram father, mother. Your connection with me goes down to the lower level if the integrity gets reduced. I was wondering, what is the way we can bring people to the higher integrity immediately and the feeling connection, so they start manifesting the powers, they start staying in the space of Sadashivatva. Sadashiva revealed a beautiful sound. I can tell you, this is like a password. At any point, if you are not able to bring yourself to oneness, you are a little shaken, disturbed, or for some reason, you are not able to bring yourself to oneness. This is like a password. You type, whether your mind feels connected or not, the energy will start flowing in you beyond the depth dimension. You see, all mind oscillation, restlessness, all mental idea based feeling connected or not feeling connected is only length, breadth, depth level, not in the space level. But this sound will straight infuse energy from the space level. Like, for example, if the power goes off, automatically the generator will get switched on and the power supply will be going on. So end result will not be lost. Whether government power supply or the generator power supply, end result will not be stopped. So whenever you feel little that oneness is, you are not catching it, just feed this password. Immediately the oneness will open up and you will start manifesting the powers, energy, and the whole space will shift. It is directly from Sadashiva. It's a beautiful sound. I don't even want to say it's a mantra. It is not even a mantra because there is no meaning in it. You can't derive a meaning for it. It just flashed like a password for all the initiations I am giving. One single password for all the initiations I am giving. And the initiations I gave, I am giving, I will be giving for all that. This is like one password. Don't even repeat like a mantra. Just feed like a password and it will just open up. Your whole being will open up. Listen carefully. It starts with the vibration, Om. Listen and then repeat. Om. Very deep. Om. Nityananda. Nityananda. Maha. Sadashivoham.
So Bhagwan gave beautiful explanation of how you can be in Shaktipada. Visualize Paramashiva who has come down as Bhagwan Nityananda Paramashivam from Kailasha. Remembering Paramashiva in your third eye, again and again, bringing your awareness to your third eye simply makes you manifest powers. Absolute unclutching, how Bhagwan said, the neutral zone, nothing ever touches the screen. Like same way, the movie does not touch the screen, whether it is happening in ferocious or any soft, beautiful, nothing touches the screen. Be unclutched like the screen. And to experience the state of Paramashiva, your inner space being completely unclutched. Complete completion to experience the space of Paramashiva. Inside us, the complete completion happens when we are in tune with Paramashiva. That everything is redundant and irrelevant. The essence of completion is irrelevant. Nothing matters in your life because everything is complete completion. Oneness with Paramashiva. How Bhagwan said, in ferocious breaking the boredom and tiredness, just being in the space of oneness with Paramashiva to manifest the powers of Paramashiva. Tyaga, as Paramashiva is your only strength, now declaring complete integrity with Bhagwan to experience the being of Paramashiva. How Bhagwan said, chanting the Mahavakya raises your frequency and that is your only strength to manifest any reality. Being in this beautiful space of Paramashiva, you can experience such a beautiful space, state, powers, and becoming the being of Paramashiva, manifesting whatever you want. Now, you will be manifesting the powers, watching the oneness capsule and chanting the Mahavakya, Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. We'll be playing the Mahavakya and the oneness capsule for you to manifest powers. At end of the Mahavakya, you can start with the verification and sharing and causing. Thank you.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. 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 Om Nityananda
Namashivam. Om Nityananda Paramashivam.
Let Paramashiva third eye manifest in all our third eye. Let the Amrita pour. Let the Varni open up. Manifest in all of us. Let Paramashiva overflow, manifest the power in all of our third eye. Om Nityananda Paramashivam. 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 Nityananda Paramashivam. Om Nityananda Paramashivam. Om Nityananda Paramashivam. Nityananda Paramashivam. Om Nityananda Paramashivam. Om Nityananda Paramashivam. Let Paramashiva's third eye manifest in all our third eye. Let the Amrita pour. Let the Varni open up. Manifest in all of us. Let Paramashiva overflow, manifest the power in all of our third eye. Om Nityananda Paramashivam. 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 Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om 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 Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Let Paramashiva's third eye manifest in all our third eyes. Let the Amrita pour. Let the Varni open up.
Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Let Paramashiva's third eye manifest in all our third eyes. Let the Amrita pour. Let the Varni open up. Manifest in all of us. Let Paramashiva overflow, manifest the powers in all of our third eyes.
Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम्
परम शिवोऽहम् परम शिवोऽहम्
लेट् परम शिवस् थर्ड् ऐ मैनिफेस्टिंग ऑल अवर थर्ड् ऐ
परम शिवोऽहम्
लेट् द अमृत पूर Let the Vanni open up, manifest in all of us.
Paramashivoham, 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 Paramashivoham.
Let Paramashiva overflow, manifest the power in all of our third
नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परम
Paramashivoham. Om Jnananda Paramashivoham. Om Jnananda Paramashivoham.
Let Paramashiva's third eye manifest in all our third eyes. Let the Amrita pour. Let the
Om Jnananda Paramashivoham. 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 Om Jnananda Paramashivoham.
Let Paramashiva's third eye manifest in all our third eyes. Let the Amrita pour. Let the Varni open up. Manifest in all of us. Let Paramashiva overflow, manifest the power in all of our third eyes.
Om Jnananda Paramashivoham. 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 Om Jnananda
Paramashivoham.
Verification process, no video editing or on Shakti Aveshana videos. Verify the video is not stopped or restarted. All videos should be verified with a timestamp and a wide angle. No clues or hints during manifestation. No Bluetooth or gadget during manifestation. If you'd like to use the Garbha Aushadha Mandala, wonderful. Authentically write the past tragedy and the reason and match it exactly as it reveals in the third eye. Do not tamper the verification process, and the reasons are given for more healing to happen. Do not justify or tamper all these details. Do it as authentically as possible. More authenticity, more power manifestation happens. Thank you for choosing Akashic Reading, Power of Akashic Reading of Past Tragedy and the Reasons Behind It.
Beautiful. We are at the end of the power manifestation, but most important part of the power manifestation. Here, we are going to share all that you have manifested with the social media groups. Here we have Sri Kailasha Kotiyar Manifesting Power Groups. Thousands of people are part of that. And you can share there and you can post your powerful cognition and the videos. The link is tinyurl.com/powermanifestation. It is at the left corner of the page. You can click on it and you can post your beautiful experience in the power manifestation group. Why sharing and causing is very important part of power manifestation. Bhagwan beautifully explains that sharing is pulling us out of delusion and causing is liberating us. We are the ones who need to start experiencing the higher states of reality, how we need to exist. Beautifully, Bhagwan explains, when you are sharing with others the ultimate beautiful multidimensional logic, your brain rewires into the higher space of consciousness, the Turiyatita state. Again and again, when you experience even a little bit, you share with the world, your experience becomes reality. Same thing when you cause others to come and get initiated for higher reality, you are caused into the higher purpose, the ultimate reality. Bhagwan says extreme causing, extreme power manifestation is extreme causing. So beautifully he explains how we, our strength is declared on Paramashiva, the power manifestation happens exactly in tune to that. And sharing with the world, continuously reiterating ourselves, the experience that we had from the powerful cognition and manifesting the space of Paramashiva, the state of Paramashiva, the beings of Paramashiva, we become Paramashiva. Go on sharing and causing, which is the most important part of how you have experienced your reality. When you go to a temple, we pray and we see that beautiful experience happen in us and then share with the world that how amazing the temple experience has manifested as your reality. Same way, when you manifest powers, when you share with the world, it becomes more and more the depth cognition of you and you will be experiencing more powers. Even if you're manifested very small, it does not matter the quantity, Bhagwan says. The quality is important. If it is authentic, please go ahead and share with the world. Do not doubt, have self-doubt, self-denial, self-hatred come and block anything. Experience the ultimate in deep seeking and gratitude. Bhagwan manifests in you with a deep prayer that asking Bhagwan to make this reality as your existential reality. With that, let's end with the Purna Mantra, thanking Bhagwan for all these great experience. We have come to the end of the Power Manifestation course and we end with the Purna Mantra. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purna Purnamadashyate Purnasya Purnamataya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti 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 Hi. Hari Om Tat Sat Sarvam Bhagavate Sri Nityananda Paramashivam Paduka Arpanamastu. Om Nityanandam. Thank you for participating in the Jnanapatati, Nityananda Jnanapatati course. Please go ahead and select more power manifestation and every day experience the ultimate reality for yourself. Nityananda.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.